Because picture books are character-based, generally, I have to get the characters in my head. So once I've got the story and if I like the story, I then will go to character design. So say with the Aliens Love Underpants books, I had to think of what an alien was going to look like. I would start with the sketch pad, which is usually empty at this point, and start roughing out ideas for how the alien's going to look. I wanted to get a friendly-looking character. I didn't want my aliens looking particularly scary, because they're not meant to be. They're not coming to invade the world, they're coming to steal your underpants. Once I've got the characters, I'll then progress to where they're actually living or the environment they're going to be in. In this case, they were coming down to Earth, so you'll have them in their spaceships, and then you'll have them in the humans' environment. I will start roughing out the bigger spreads, which is what we do here. This one comes from Aliens and Underpants Save the World, and this spread is all about the aliens who've stolen our underpants and they're stitching them together to make a giant pair of pants to send this meteorite, which is going to land on Earth if they don't do that, and destroy the world and all the pants supply. You have to make sure within the artwork there's a place where you can print the type. I could get carried away and think, oh, I'll do this lovely picture, and then all of a sudden I think, where am I going to put the type? So you always have to be aware of that. And in fact, when you're painting a book, they can look slightly strange because you have this nice picture with lots and lots of detail, and all of a sudden there's like a fairly boring area, and you think, well, if someone came and saw that, I think, why haven't you put stuff in there? But you can't, because in this picture, I knew the text had to fit in roughly there, and there was going to be a couple of lines, so I've left the space there for the type to go in. Once this has been okayed, I then go to the finished artwork, which is the painted part, and this is probably the bit that takes me the longest. So a spread like this one, which is obviously very similar to this, although as you can see here, he's got spots. And when I came to paint it, I didn't put spots in. This one hasn't got stripes, but then I added them. So it varies. You do adjust pictures as you're going along, but my roughs and my finished artwork are generally very similar composition-wise. So then I paint the artwork, I send that off to the publishers who then send it to the printers. And the next time I see this will be what they call proofs, which is like a color version of this printed out. And if the colors are okay, we then go to the final book, which is then what you see here with the finished artwork and the type in position. And that's how you get from characters, rough drawing, and then through to the final artwork and then into the bookshops.